Ang akong pangandoy,
pangarap ko.
Pangarap ko.
Pangarap ko.
Pangarap ko.
Pangarap ko ang pagkakaisa ng Muslim at Kristiyano para sa payapang Pilipinas.
Pangarap ko, tahimik na mga komunidad, walang krimen o nagkalat na droga.
Pangarap ko, isang gobyerno may malasakit sa tao, bibigay ng mabilis, maayos at maasahang serbisyo para sa bawat Pilipino.
Pangarap ko ang hustisya sa ating lipunan at ang pagunlad ng bawat pamilyang Pilipino.
Pangarap ko ang maging laging handa at ligtas ang bayan sa anumang sakuna.
Ang tutulong sa akin at kakampi ko, ang PDP Laban, ang partido ko. Tulungan ninyo sila. Salamat po.
Sa darating na Mayo, huwag po nating kakalimutan, tunay na pag-asa huwag nating palagpasi. Kaibigan ang bayan, pamilya ang bida. Hangarin ay magkaroon ng trabaho ang bawat pamilyang Pilipino. Proyektong pangkalasugan, edukasyon at disenteng pamumuhay. Dan Ruleta, para senador. Andito na ang ating kaibigan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa balota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Pilipino sa iba't ibang sektor, nandito na maaasahan nating senador. May puso at galing, tunay na makamasa. Kaibigan ng mahirap yan si Dan Ruleta. Pamilya ang bida, kanyang plataforma. Solusyon sa kabuhayan para sa bawat isa. Edukasyon sa kanya ang mahalaga, at may maayos na tirahan ang bawat pamilya. Sino ba ang dapat nating iboto? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino ba ating maaasahan? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino may malasakit sa bayan? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino ba ang dapat sa Senado? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Andito na ang ating kaibigan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Dapat tayo ay magsama-sama upang tulungan si Dan Ruleta. Sa serbisyo ay tapat at totoo, senador na sigurado na hindi magloloko. Dapat tayo ay magsama-sama upang tulungan si Dan Ruleta. Sa serbisyo ay tapat at totoo, at sa darating na Mayo siya ang aking ibuboto. Serbisyong totoo na maglilingkod sa bayan, ang dapat na subukan natin pagkatiwalaan. Siya ating kailangan at maaasahan na tao sa pusong maglingkod sa bayan. Maraming natulungan, subok sa serbisyo, epektibong plataforma sa pamilyang Pilipino. Sa darating na Mayo, sinong ibuboto mo? Si Dan Ruleta ang kailangan sa Senado. Subok na sa serbisyo yung publiko, tunay na pag-asa na hangad ng taong bayan. Dan Ruleta, wala nang dapat patunayan, makatao, makadiyos at makabayan. Andito na ang ating kaibigan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta.
President Ma'am Maria Risa Pastor, and of course students, our senior high school students, guests. Good morning. Happy Thursday morning to all of us. We are very happy and proud to welcome you to this two-day seminar, Senior High School Expo and Job Fair. Happy because you really took time out from your busy schedule to be with us today. We are also proud to showcase to you the quality outputs of our students, which vary from products to services to performance. You name it and we have it. Do take time to examine the products on display, some of which are also for sale. Our students also offer some beauty care services, such as skin, nail care, foot spa, and even massage. Our performing arts students from Tagum City National High School will entertain you with their songs and dances. Some of you are here because you may be scouting for students who want to work after graduation. They are your prospective employees. Not to mention, or not to be outdone, our teachers are also proud to present their learning resources, innovations to improve classroom instruction. All this and more await you here at our Senior High School Expo and Job Fair. Thank you and enjoy our 2 days Senior High School Expo and Job Fair. God bless us all.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dr. Rosemary T. Masasar. You can jump, you can jump, you can jump, you can jump, you can jump. Matungub City National High School Special Program in the R-Stars. Thank you so much. Shall we give them another warm applause, ladies and gentlemen? This time, to deliver his message, one of the leaders of transformation, innovation, and of course, the promotion of quality education here in Tangub City. Ladies and gentlemen, our City Vice Mayor, Dr. Edimar S. Alata.
Thank you very much, Sir Jerwell, at mapagpahan si Sir Jerwell. Mauni iingon niya, in the absence of the City Mayor, the Vice Mayor will always take his place. We are not supposed to be here this morning because of our schedule to the different barangays. So, you will notice na ako lang, yung atong EDCOM chair, all about Pinotrio Almohoro are here with the instruction of the City Mayor na disamin mo ako sa barangay kami duha. Just to show, just to give our support to the program, to this particular program of the Department of Education. Because you all know that here in Kapu, the number one flagship program is education. So we cannot say no to every invitation of our Division Superintendent, Jean Deloso. And of course, we are very happy that with us this morning is the father of Deep Ed, Region 10, Director R. Mayoko. Ito pagpangkan si Director. And of course, with him, are the members of the Regional Senior High School Monitoring Team. So we have here Madam Mary Ann Neri, the Chief Administrative Officer, Budget and Finance, DepEd Region 10. And of course, the Education Program Supervisor, Dr. Noel Ilahin. So, kanalipay po ko na ang atong mga ginikanan na usa sa mga stakeholders sa senior high school is being represented by no less than the Federated President of the of Kapu City's Federated Parents Teachers Association in the person of Maria Risa Astor. Nalipay pa dyan po kay naipipila sa itong mga kapitalis na naagyod na bintun mga kapitan na naay high school na ay senior high school sa ilang barangay. At ang pagpaka na itong mga kapitalis. And of course, ang mga stars sa itong kalihukan karon ang atong 14 senior high schools here in Tangub City being clustered into 4 clusters. Dila na ko mention. Basta 14 senior high school na itong i-cluster into 4. Atong pagpakan with their able principals or administrators. So thank you very much. So once again, good morning. It is my pleasure to be standing in front of you today to give you a message in behalf of the father of the city of Tangub, Mayor Philip Tan, who is now in Cagayate Oro City attending the RDC. So we all know that Mayor Philip Tan is the chair of one of the sectors of RDC, particularly the EFRA sector. I really appreciate activities like this. an event which is being organized to showcase the talents, skills, and entrepreneurial spirit of our students, an exposition, an exhibition of crafts. This is really a great avenue in empowering our students, the senior high school students, for employment, entrepreneurship, and for college opportunities. And a lead by the Sakapu, Kaduha, ka colleges, public colleges, nga mo cater in kaso o gusto mo mo avail sa college opportunities. We have the governor of also Dita College and the Northeastern Mindanao State College of Science and Technology, which status, a university status, was already approved and signed by no less than the President, President Rodrigo Duterte. At ang pagpakan ang NMSC, napakatawag ko na siya o University of Northeastern Mindanao. Empowerment. That's one of the key words in our theme this morning. How do we really empower students? These senior high school students who are expected to be not only academically strong, but also well-rounded individuals. This two-day exposition and job fair encompasses the answers to the question of how prepare our senior high school students to enter into either of the three destinations. Again, the three destinations of our high school, of our senior high school students or senior high school graduates are: one, employment; second, entrepreneurship; and the third, college opportunities. First, we empower our senior high school students by allowing them to creatively express themselves as we expose them to meaningful experiences such as this expo and job fair. We give them critical skills that they will use in many areas for their entire lives. Nalipay kayo ko, I was informed that all the senior high school students who will graduate is coming, some graduation are in situ passers. No? Naa ang Sumirap National High School. So, again, to Sumirap National High School. Second, we empower our senior high school students through our support in innovation. We cannot deny the fact that the millennials today are very innovative. Like a caterpillar which undergoes metamorphosis to become a butterfly. These young minds are transforming the old tedious methods and process of solving and meeting challenges into their own innovative solutions. Instead of conforming to the old standards, they are opting to define and build their own ladder to the top. As the incubators for ideas, innovativeness, and inspiration, we are transforming the senior high school students into self-directed learners who will know how to manage themselves in a variety of situations. In the demanding environment in college, university, or in a workplace, we empower our students when we help them determine what they want to seek for the job that is as satisfying to the human spirit as it is satisfying economically. This expo and job fair is a learning experience that will greatly help our senior high school students to get in touch with who they want to be and what they want to accomplish in this world. Today's event, organized by the Department of Education through the efforts of the Mother of Education, Ma'am Jean Peloso, together with ESDS Rosemary Macisar and the entire staff of DPED, Tacloc City Division, gives our senior high school students and everyone the opportunity to transform their optimism, dreams, and hopes into tangible social impacts. Before I end my note, I would like to read to you a meaningful message of an author, Roy Bennett, and I quote, "You are unique. Each one of you here, each one of our senior high school students is unique. Remember that. You have different talents and abilities. You do not have to always follow the footsteps of others. And most importantly, you should always remind yourself that you do not have to do what everyone else is doing. So you must make a difference. You have the responsibility to develop the talents that you have been given." So to our senior high school students, congratulations in advance for the job well done. And once again, good morning, and I wish everyone to have a meaningful time in the Senior High School Expo at Job Fair. Daghang salamat kung ang Ginoo magapanalangin kanatong tanan.
Ladies and gentlemen, our City Vice Mayor, Honorable Edmar S. Salonga. This time, ladies and gentlemen, to formally introduce our keynote speaker for this year's exposition, ladies and gentlemen, our school's division superintendent, a warm applause for Ma'am G.G. Veloso.
Thank you. Good morning to our City Vice Mayor, Honorable Edmar Alonga, to the Chairman of the Committee on Education, Honorable Teo Alvaro, to our partner, Federated PTA President, Madam Marionisa Pastor. We have with us, of course, our partners from the regional office, Madam Mary Ann Neri, Dr. Noel Pelagio, and our keynote speaker, whom I'll be formally introduced in a little while, ASDS Rosemary Macisar, CID Chief, Madam Ami Hubay, members of the DPED Tacloc City Manong family, parents, teachers, and of course, our 2,342 senior high school stars. Good morning. Good morning.
Good morning.
We also have with us our partner from the media. Thank you so much for joining us. Our keynote speaker rose from the rank from master teacher to teacher in charge, education program supervisor, assistant school's division superintendent, and school's division superintendent in our neighbor region, Region 9. Before his assignment in Region 10, he was the regional director of Region 12. He had a number of educational travels as follows. He's a Philippine delegate to the 2009 International Visitors Leadership Program in the USA, covering Washington, D.C., Minnesota, Texas, and Florida. He also attended the Educational Engagement Program of Summer 2011 in Istanbul, Turkey, the Language, Science, and Math Expedition in Vietnam, Cambodia, and Thailand,
he presented the Philippine Country Board in Education entitled Making Character as Bedrock of Competence, Excellence, and Instruction in the ASEAN Council of Teachers Convention in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia in 2013. He also presented the Philippine Country Report in Education, balancing the teaching activities in the classroom with the crucial professional upgrading activities for teachers in the 30th Asian Council of Teachers Convention in Singapore in 2014. He attended the Asia Pacific Region Course for Leader Trainer Sanction City, South Korea in 2015. And he attended a number of recent educational travels in New York City in 2018 and in 2019. He is holding the following positions: PPSTA National Board of Trustees, National Board of Director, Philippine Educators Association of CESOS and Eligibles, PEACE Incorporated. The President of PEACE Incorporated Region 9 Chapter, President of Zamboanga Sur Sibugay Pagadian City Teachers Association, President, Vice President of the Philippine Association of School Superintendent of Region 9, a fellow member of the Royal Institute of Educators Singapore, and the Vice President of St. Columban College Alumni Association. Ladies and gentlemen, our keynote speaker, whose excellence, integrity, and compassion have inspired and changed lives of the many, the Regional Director of DepEd Region 10, Dr. Arturo B. Bayongon Sesopan.
I would like to start off my greetings by giving special recognition to the dynamism of the executive head of this city, our very dynamic, honorable Philip Tang, the city mayor, who has put education in his top priority governance agenda. I think everybody agrees with me that he is an education champion. And even if he's not around because he is the chairman of the Infrastructure Sectoral Committee of the Regional Development Council and I'm meeting karon dito sa Cagayan de Oro, I am supposed to attend, but I just requested my assistant director, Attorney Chapo, to represent me. Kay kahapon po nag-present ang region DepEd sa budget for 2020 dito sa Regional Development Council under the Social Sectoral Committee with Governor Aquin Dimapuro, Governor Danao as the chairperson. Ang ato ang presidente sa usa ka eskwelahan who has evolved time and again and now one of the prides of the city on its conversion to be university, Dr. Jennifer Tan. Ang atong suki na Vice Mayor, amigo na kayo ni Ani, no? Kita lang ko niya, he gives me a positive aura and set my mood that there is always a good thing to celebrate day after day. And that's the optimism and positivity in the person of Honorable Mayor, Vice Mayor Ed Alona. Ato ang committee chair education in the council, at the city council, si Honorable Teo ang Lohoro. Mga officials who are here, ang ato ang Department of Education family, spearheaded of course by the very active Jean Veloso, not so young, but very young at the service, but has proven her worth to be a leader worthy of emulation in the practices that she has modeled in Tangkub as her first assignment as superintendent. When it is first, there will always be second, third, and fourth. But we will cross the fingers in terms of her career path and where fate would bring her in the division assignments. Our very active assistant school division superintendent, Rose Macesar. Si Rose is also an epitome of how art should be celebrated. Dili art na yung word. Art, as in art culture. Remember, we have beautiful dancers who have given us a prelude to what is the celebration that we are doing today. And they are students of the special program in the arts. And si Rose Macesar has been a good example in terms of her musical prowess. Rose, may tayo na-example na nagkakaroon. Ang atong General Federated PTA President who is always backing up in terms of governance agenda in DepEd. We cannot do all things in DepEd all by ourselves. We have to partner, mobilize our organizations, especially our Parents Teachers Association. Ma'am, thank you for joining with us. Sa akong biyahe karon, kauban usab nato ang chair. Aning ako po yung karon mo ni hari sa mga kapwartahan sa regional office. She gives advice to the director in terms of how fiscal management should be strengthened. I'm referring to the chief of the finance division at the regional office, Madam Mary Ann Mary, CPA. Kauban usab nato si Noel Pinahio, who is under the Quality Assurance Division, a very important division in the region. Because as I was saying when I delivered my message during the regional meet, ang bureaucracia sa DepEd, ang central office is policy formulation. Nandoon ang mga madudunong na tao upang magbuo ng mga reforma para sa edukasyon. Ngunit, ang kanilang trabaho is only to make policies, formulate policies. The regional office is quality assurance, monitoring, and evaluation as the macro functions of the office. O na si Noel Pinahio is with the quality assurance. Isa sa trabaho o mandato ng ating kagawaran ng edukasyon sa regional level to assure quality of inputs, delivery, the way DepEd should go. And of course, ang ikatlo, ang pangatlong bahagdan, ang pangatlong, tawag yan, ang pangatlong antas ng ating bureaucracia ay ang divisions, districts, and schools, and we call them the implementing level of governance. Actions are taking place at your level. So DepEd at the central office cannot go somewhere if the manpower at the implementing level will not really do the function. Kumbaga, kayo po ang nagpapagalaw ng katawaran. We are more than 800,000 employees in the Department of Education. And 700,000 more of that are those under the implementing level of governance where you all belong. Ang atong mga principals of the secondary high schools, I'm happy that even our private school, local, and state colleges that offer senior high school are also joining as we showcase today the skills of our students that we have to celebrate and as we open our eyes to realities in terms of the curriculum exits as promised by the Department of Education. Karon pa lang po magsugod sa akong istorya, sa akong message, introduction pa lang kong ganina. At the start, when we implemented K-12, marami sa inyo were very skeptical, cynical, negative about the reform. Kaya mo ingon mo, sus, sa kanyang college naman ang takuron. Naghapit-hapit pa ng panin senior high school. And hindi lang po kayo ang medyo may negatibong pananaw tungkol doon sa reforma ng ating curriculum. Ate ng mga magulang, because what registered in the minds of our parents ay ang dagdag gastos upang matapos ang sekundarya para makapag-proceed to college. But year after year and time after time, we have accepted and embraced the realities that this is a better curriculum than the past. Hindi naman ibig sabihin na ang mga produkto sa mga nakaraang panahon ay kulang din sa mga kakayahan. Kami, produkto kami noong unang panahon. We don't claim that we are the best. But if you see good, if you see us good today, kung produkto pa lang tayo sa K-12, we could have been better today. If you see the goodness in us today, then that would have been doubled if we were products of a K-12 curriculum where 2 years are added in the high school, which are geared towards skill development years. Ang senior high school, lahat po yung core subjects, English, math, science. But the emphasis of senior high school is honing the skills of our students to better prepare them when they proceed to what's gonna happen of them after senior high school. In my cell phone, para sa kasayuran sa tanan, ingon si Jean Veloso kanina, ikaw mo'y tatay sa region na ang anak perting naghana. If you don't know, the enrollment of Northern Mindanao for this year is able to reach to the tune of 1,236,000 students enrolled in the schools, both public and private, LUCs and SUCs in the region of Northern Mindanao. Grabe, milyones ang estudyante. Ingon ana ka produktibo ang ato mga ginikanan. Kusog mo gamag bata. We reach to 1.2 million. But if we look at the senior high school, which were part of the pilot years, hindi sa pilot, the early year implementation, and we have sacrificed so much birth pains in delivering the senior high school, DVA as announced by Dr. Jean Veloso, there are more than 2,000 senior high school students in this division. And part of the 2,000 are those beautifully seated at the bleachers now for this celebration. You have 14 high schools. Kanina parang kinulang sa enthusiasm ang ibang estudyante nung sila yung pinakilala ng ating principal. Pero yung Tangub City National High School, masyadong energetic sa pagpapakilala. Pwede ba? Parinig ko ang sigaw ng kabataan, senior high schools ng buong lungsod ng Tangub. In a count of three, give me the loudest clap and shouts. 1, 2, 3! Ito wala tayo ni Ria, huwag ko na matin lang. Walang ko naminaw na kung katong wala na react. Now, if I will look at the enrollment of senior high school in the region, it's 128,622. Earlier, ang sabi ko, 1.2 million over ang enrollment mula kindergarten hanggang senior high. If we go to the breakdown, how many represent the senior high school? It's 128,622. And over 2,000 are contributed by the city of Tacloban. Anyway, ang karoon na tuig, hindi pa dapat nagkumpiyansa. Why? Because the eyes of the Philippines are on us. Many people, officials, private individuals ay nagduda pa rin sa kakayahan ng DepEd upang maibigay natin ang ating ipinangako sa ating bandang people. Ano yung promise ng DepEd? We promise that after senior high school, we will be able to hold our senior high school graduates ever ready for the three curriculum exits na pinangako. The first one is their further ads to college education. Nagtanong ako kay Dr. Jean Deloso. Jean, sa 2,000 plus na senior high school, ilan ang nagpahayag ng intensyon upang mag-proceed to college by virtue of their choice in the specific track at senior high school? Sabi ni Jean, it is still overruled by academic track. Academic track like general academic strand, like ABM, accountancy, business, and management, and then STEM, science, technology, engineering, math. So, eto, overall pa rin, I did not have the exact figure. But according to Jim, majority are still taking the academic track. Is this something to be worried about? Of course not. Because senior high school is still putting on priority the furtherance to college education. And good that Tangub City students still have the burning desire to proceed to college education. That's why you go for your academics, you're seeing that quality college education are just delivered in your doorsteps. Because you have got VC, you even have now a university. I came from Pagadian City. There is not a university in our city. Our city has been established since 1965. We have colleges, but we didn't have a university. Tangub now has at least in the startup level of the conversion, and you only have to finish the compliance of the requirements and eventually operate as a university maybe next year. That's a good advantage. At ang mga estudyante, nakita nila yan. Kaya kinuha pa rin nila ang track on academics. Thank you for that. But what about the tech book track, the arts and designs, the sports? These are still good preparations, not for work, but for the rest of college. Halimbawa, nag-bread and pastry ka in your track. That will still better prepare you for a course in college that has relevance to your strength. And what is that? You can enroll in Bachelor of Home Economics. Ang dami pong kurso sa kolehiyo na pinaghandaan dapat sa ating TechBook tracks in the senior high school. So, even the vocational technology tracks, these are still preparation for college. Ngunit, hindi lingin sa ating kaalaman that before, statistics would teach us that 1 out of 10 high school graduates cannot proceed to college because of preconditions that are beyond their capacities, especially on the financial side. Karon, ang education, kayo-kayo ng handog ka ng education for all, no one left behind. At kailangan magpakatuto tayo sa ating mantra. Even if just 1 out of 10 that can go to college, 1 is still very significant. Kaya ang ating senior high school ay pinanday upang ang bawat isa ay mabigyan ng karampatang halagahan. So, big yun kaya o college, you enroll at TechBook track because that is also your expertise. Senior high school K-12 gives a promise that after graduation to senior high, there is high employability. Ibig sabihin, kapag maghanap kayo ng trabaho, pagkatapos ng senior high school, there is an easier chance for you to get hired because you already have demonstrated and honed the skills. Tomorrow, I was coached by superintendent na ang araw na to ay i-google na to demonstrate your skills as we exhibit our senior high school products, and we call this Expo. Bukas, and ang inyong gagawin is the job fair, and we expect that the PESO at the city government, kung saan ang PESO? Public Employment Service Office, ang Department of Labor and Employment, ang atong mga establishments, like kung saan ang mga establishments dito dito, mga tindahan, mga hardware, all of them have been invited, I assume, by the Department of Education. They will put up some tables here, and even the air-conditioned room is prepared for the interview and the outspot hiring of those who are really determined to get employment because they still cannot proceed to college by June. So bukas, gusto kong malaman dito sa inyo kung ilan ang mayroong automatic hiring dahil ipinasan nyo ang interview at ipinasan nyo ang performance demonstration of the skill that is required by the local market in Bangor City. Kagabi, natulog ako sa Royal Garden Hotel na Masamis. Nanood ako ng local channels. Napanood ko ang inyong mga politiko nagkukwento tungkol sa inyong lalawigan at inyong bayan ng Tangkog, and giving good promises of the future that this province and city have in store for. Pero kanina, unaninaw mo, ninong ko, very critical still this year kasi ang mga mata ng tao ay nakatingin sa atin kung napapatupad ba, kung walang banka, makuinihon na promises are made to be broken. Tingnan natin kung ang promises ng DepEd are broken. Alam nyo, ang DepEd, sa senior high school program, meron kayong 80 hours work immersion. You go to the businesses, industries, you hone your skills, it's just like internship or on-the-job training. Ngayon, hindi rin lingid sa kaalaman, ang dami din kakulangan ng DepEd. Number one, tech, EDL tools and equipment were not delivered to schools on time. Kasi ang dami procurement details na dapat pasadahan, sundan. So, unsa may nakita mo? Ang katong 80 minutes work immersion, is that enough hands-on preparation of the student who were taught with the principals and theories in the classroom? DepEd did not miss a chance to better prepare the student. Unsay gihimo mo sa Department of Education? Bisan ang work immersion na aduna paghiapon, naghimo ta og JDVP, the Joint Delivery Voucher Program. Unsa man na? Ang bata kung adto sa technology education institutions, teacher education, technology education institutions, na naa sa inyong komunidad, i-partner sa DepEd, ibayaran sa DepEd of 12,000 kada bata para kung adto mo dito, and there is hands-on training apart from or on top of your work immersion. And we believe that today, as you exhibited the outputs, these are proofs and evidences that we really have prepared our students on their performance requirements. Ay, grabe yun kayo, atong gihimo karon sa DepEd. Kailan mo ni Henry Ford? Si Henry Ford is a business magnate. He is an icon in the industry. He is an entrepreneur, sikat na tao. Siya ang founder sa Ford Car Company, Ford Motor Company. Ano mga Ford yung sakyanan? Oh, sikat kayo na siya. Siya ay naniniwala. Ang paniniwala ni Henry Ford is that no one can replace the person, as the human capital that will make the things for this world. Technology, taon-taon, merong bagong invention. Wala akong makakapalit na technology sa tao. So ladies and gentlemen, the human resource is still the best resource. And keep summoning human resource. Our senior high school students who will soon graduate. That's why FN Region and City of Tambo believe that it is always putting the grandeur investment to human capital that will change this city and the entire region and this world. Anong sinabi ni Henry Ford? Coming together is the beginning. Kung ito'y mahaba-habang paglalakbay, magsisimula po yan sa pagpunta to start that beginning. But it's not just one coming, but coming together. Today, we have come together. The private, the LUC, SUC, the senior high school. Nag-display tayo. Hindi ito kompetisyon, pero para na rin naging kompetisyon. Habang kayo ay naglalagay ng mga palamuti sa inyong mga boots, nag-iisip kayo, dapat pagandahin pa natin ito kaysa ating kapitbahay. Oh, anawan ninyo na inyong gallery karon. Ninyong kunindot yung kayo. Akong iganahan pag yun, nanihan ninyo gibutang diri sa gym. Kahit matutukan na ito, ibisang tibukan daw kamang pundo ng inyong boot, kaya kayo. Sa Cagayan de Oro, they did it at Buluwat National High School Ground. All the high schools of Cagayan. Maayo na po, naghimo sila ang mga booth. Pero kami in town ng mga gallery walkers, magdali-dali yung iwas na yung pasilong, kahaskan yung kinita. So naluoy ko mga display, walang yung kaayo na tangkaw sa mga tao, kaya nagpunay lang panampli, nangitin, nangita ang lando. While here in Tango, you're doing it in an air-conditioned facility. So swerte, pagkit mo palang ka ni Mayor, higit mo pagkatingin ko nani. Mahal ka tingali ni bayan. Sige, libre pang wani. So thank you very much. And bakit higit tayong taon na upang gawin dito ang ating patimpalak o ang ating activity? Because you have built partnership and collaboration with our education partners like the local government union. Ano po na silang gal, silang vice mayor, ano po na silang gusto magigay na sila ng mga pagtabang sa mga eskwelahan? Nag-alam ang anak sa ilang mga constituents, binisayon ang anak sa ilang mga butante. Yung takuan mo yun, may eleksyon na ba? Ang anak sa mga katauhan sa Tango, naaman sa mga tulungan. And if they don't give their best support, then these children would not have availed of best service delivery from the Department of Education. So no man is an island. Henry Ford said, we come together so we can start a good beginning. Pero hindi lang po hanggang doon ang sinabi ni Henry. Si Henry, okay lang siya. Mas dato pa ng Henry C. na tag-iya sa SM Supermalls. Namatay na rin ba si Henry C. Si Henry Ford, dato po lang sa kayo. Tag-iya po na ng mga sakyanan na Ford. Tapos yung mga Ford Everest. Ayun na. So ngayon, hindi pa rin siya naniniwala that it is enough to come together. Because according to him, staying together is progress. Punta tayo sabay-sabay, but we have to stay on together. Because by doing that, we see progress in the things that we do. But it is not up to that level. Hindi pa ganun. Kasi ang paniniwala ng isang business magnate ay, anong pangatlong sinabi niya? Sabi niya, working together is success. It is not enough that you come, it is not enough that you stay, but what is demanded is you work and we work together if we want to get success. Ito ang pagdiriwang ng tagumpay na ating nagawa. Pero hindi pa po ito ang rurok ng tagumpay. Because what is more important is what's gonna happen in our lives after senior high school. Teachers, alam ko kayo'y nagpupunyagi at di dyan kayo dapat na pagpupugay dahil kayo ay naghirap at nagsikap upang matulungan ng mga bata kahit may kakulangan ang ating kakawaran. But you have traveled this far at eto po ay naitawid ninyo ang taong ito. Ito po ay isang signales ng inyong pagiging produktibong guro. Ako, teacher ko spoken, 13 katuig. Dili ko ma-underestimate kung sa kalisod ma-assign sa bukid. But to me, now that I'm full-fledged director, I could still count that the best chapters of my career were those that I spent in the bukid when I was a bukid elementary grade teacher. Doon ko rin, you know, if you want me, nakadungog ko sa iyo ni Jim, adto na ko Amerika, adto na ko sa kasa, nag-present ko ang mga research. Yes, that was true. And the latest of my travel was in Washington, D.C. and in New York last December when I, before sa regional meet, when I attended together with Undersecretary Sevilla, the workshop on public financial management. So, kurang nakalakot-nabot, pero dili yun na ako mahimong hikalintan. Ang 13 katuig na akong experience as a grade 6 classroom teacher. Because to me, that was the best experience that has prepared me to what I am now at present as a leader in education. Sige, kung ikapoy na mo, kung saan lang yun ka ako, as ay kapoy, ang usinggit o ang maminaw, ang kapoy yun ang usinggit. So, congratulations to Tangub City Schools, both of the public and private. This is a big step in a million miles of journey. But a big step success, because right now we shall be able very soon to see how our students will demonstrate in action the theories and principles that we taught them inside the four walls of the classrooms. And the products would also tell that they were able to deliver that. Ugma ang tagna sa pagpanudya. Kay ugma na ang interview, job interviews for those who were already disinterested of getting into jobs. Ang pangako ng DepEd, maihanda tayo, mga kabataan, sa kolehiyo. And by statistics, it is still very convincing that Tangub schools are still putting number one as a curriculum exit on their furtherance to tertiary education. Second, ang pangako, pangalawang pangako ng DepEd ay dapat ang senior high school graduates ay maihanda sa trabaho. Pag hindi kinayang pumasok sa kolehiyo, maghanahanda ng ating mga estudyante para sa negosyo. You go to work, you go to college, you go to business. And the entrepreneurial aspect where we train you how to handle small-scale businesses would always be the beginning of greater things in the future. Salamat. It is my honor and privilege to be back again in Tangub and to share to you the promises of DepEd as we collaborate with each one. Let us continue to deliver our best. And my favorite line of ending my message is, there is one up there that looks over us, who understands our limitations and strengths. And one up there does not demand what our best cannot do. Ang gusto lang niya makita ang atong best. Wala siya makita of more than your best. So we just do our best. Because once we are able to do that, he up there will take care of the rest. Mabuhay, Tangub City!
Ladies and gentlemen, the Regional Director of NEPEC Region 10, Dr. Arturo Bayoko. This time, ladies and gentlemen, may I request RDR to please be here at the center as a token of love and gratitude from DEP and Tacloub City Division, together with ANCPS, Rosemary Masesor, and Vice Mayor Anota. DEP and Tacloub City Division with Mom Jean G. Veloso has something to give to RDR.
Tacloub City would like to thank Dr. Arturo B. Bayogot Sesupay, Regional Director, DepEd Region 10, for having inspired the 1,342 senior high school stars of Tacloub City. Given during the Senior High School Expo and Job Fair of Tacloub City on March 7 to 8, 2019 at Sinatuloy Cultural Center, Tacloub City.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, atong pagpagan director, Arturo Bayoko, together of course with SDS Gigi Veloso, Vice Mayor Alota, Honorable Filoteo Alcohoro, and ASDS Rose Marie Masesor. Thank you so much. Shall we give another warm applause, ladies and gentlemen? This time, the moment we've all been waiting for, as we will have the ribbon cutting of the four booths, prepared, of course, by the four cluster senior high schools here in Tacloub City. May I request RDR Bayoko, together with Mam Jean G. Veloso, the CID staff, SGOD staff, together with City Vice Mayor Dr. Elimar S. Alota, ASDS Rosemary Masesor, Honorable Filoteo Alcohoro, Honorable Philip Yonti, we will start the ribbon cutting for Cluster 1. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the process of our ribbon cutting. I will have a go signal, and then whenever your cluster will be mentioned, may I request everyone, students for that cluster, to please stand up. We will start with Cluster 1. Stand up! Tacloub City National High School and St. Michael's High School. And we will all have the countdown. Ladies and gentlemen, unveiling Cluster 1 book in 3, 2, 1, go! Let's give a hand, ladies and gentlemen, Cluster 1 with Tacloub City National High School and St. Michael's High School.
What do you wish for your meal? Are you seeking for delicious foods? Well, all you need is here at FNGN Science Carinderia. Serving your favorite viands such as Chicken Joy, Bihon, Giniling, Sinugbang Baboy, Kuso, Piniritong Isda, Egg with Beefloaf, Paklay, Nilagang Baka, Tinolang Isda, Palmakwa, Nilagang Baboy, Munggo, Istupadong Baka, Istupadong Baboy, Kumba, Chicken Curry, Kilawing Baboy. Come and taste it. We serve you the best. Visit us at FNG and Sons Carinderia, located at IBJT Agora Terminal, Ozama City.
Pangandoy,
pangarap ko
ang pagkakaisa ng Muslim at Kristiyano para sa payapang Pilipinas.
Pangarap ko, tahimik na mga komunidad, walang krimen o nagkalat na droga.
Pangarap ko, isang gobyerno may malasakit sa tao, bibigay ng mabilis, maayos at maasahang serbisyo para sa bawat Pilipino.
Pangarap ko ang hustisya sa ating lipunan at ang pagunlad ng bawat pamilyang Pilipino.
Pangarap ko ang maging laging handa at ligtas ang bayan sa anumang sakuna.
Ang tutulong sa akin at kakampi ko, ang PDP Laban, ang partido ko. Tulungan ninyo sila. Salamat po.
Sa darating na Mayo, huwag po nating kakalimutan. Tunay na pag-asa, huwag nating palagpasi. Kaibigan ang bayan, pamilya ang bida. Hangarin ay magkaroon ng trabaho ang bawat pamilyang Pilipino. Proyektong pangkalasugan, edukasyon at disenteng pamumuhay. Daan Ruleta, para senador. Andito na ang ating kaibigan. Walang iba kundi si Daan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan. Walang iba kundi si Daan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Daan Ruleta. dapat natin nabilugan sa balota. Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang Pilipino sa iba't ibang sektor, nandito na maaasahan nating senador. May puso at galing, tunay na makamasa. Kaibigan ng mahirap yan si Dan Ruleta. Pamilya ang bida, kanyang plataforma. Solusyon sa kabuhayan para sa bawat isa. Edukasyon sa kanya ang mahalaga, at may maayos na tirahan ng bawat pamilya. Sino ba ang dapat nating iboto? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino ba ating maaasahan? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino may malasakit sa bayan? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Sino ba ang dapat sa Senado? Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Andito na ang ating kaibigan. Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan. Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Dapat tayo ay magsama-sama upang tulungan si Dan Ruleta. Sa serbisyo ay tapat at totoo, senador na sigurado na hindi magloloko. Dapat tayo ay magsama-sama upang tulungan si Dan Ruleta. Sa serbisyo ay tapat at totoo, at sa darating na Mayo siya ang aking ibuboto. Serbisyong totoo na maglilingkod sa bayan, ang dapat na subukan natin pagkatiwalaan. Siya ating kailangan at maaasahan na tao sa pusong maglingkod sa bayan. Maraming natulungan, subok sa serbisyo, epektibong plataforma sa pamilya Pilipino. Sa darating na Mayo, sinong ibuboto mo? Si Dan Ruleta ang kailangan sa Senado. Subok na sa serbisyo, bisyong publiko, tunay na pag-asa na hangad ng taong bayan. Dan Ruleta, wala nang dapat patunayan. Makatao, makadiyos at makabayan. Andito na ang ating kaibigan. Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kaibigan na maaasahan. Walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Kung gusto mo ng tapat na senador, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Ang dapat natin nabilugan sa palota, walang iba kundi si Dan Ruleta. Dan Ruleta, Dan Ruleta.
as quality as the performances of our stars here on stage. So we give them a big round of applause. It is indeed so overwhelming looking at you with a super splendid performance. Congratulations. And of course, I'd like to congratulate all of the 2,342 senior high school stars of Tangkog City. Where are you? Where are you, Tangkog City stars? And of course, I'd like to say a beautiful afternoon to the stewards of the stars, your teachers. Where are you, teachers? School heads. Come on, teachers, come on, school heads, and the division of personnel in attendance with me is, of course, ASDS Rosemary Masesar. We also have CID Chief Dr. Ami Ubay. We also have with us Education Program Supervisors, the principals. We also have with us, of course, our guest speaker this afternoon. I'm so happy for having shared us his precious, her precious time. Dr. Ami Tagalugin, thank you so much for joining us. And to our friends from the media, thank you so much for being with us this afternoon. And I believe there are parents and barangay officials joining us this afternoon. I saw them also this morning. I'd like to thank you and congratulate you. Shall we give everybody a big, big round of applause? Tangkog City among the very few divisions during the Senior High School Expo. Shall we give ourselves a big round of applause? And as he went back to Osami City to catch up the 4:15 flight to Manila today for a very important meeting with the Secretary this evening, he'd like to extend his warm congratulations and gratitude to all our senior high school stars, teachers, school heads, including the LGU of Tangkog City for being very supportive. We want nothing but the best for our stars. And you showed us and presented us also the best skills exhibition, the best performances, the best products, the best learning resources, the best of what we've been giving you. You have shown those best to us today and hopefully tomorrow. The Senior High School Expo is intended to be conducted every division at the end of the school year or towards the end of the school year to remind our senior high school students of the beautiful promise of the K-12. A beautiful promise of the three destinations that you want to go after grade 12. What is the first one? First one is, which majority of you have chosen? Education or higher education, college education. Tomorrow, a number of college institutes will be joining us to do the campaign and to do preliminary screening for acceptance of college students from among you. Another thing is that for those who'd like to be employed, katong gusto mo ma-employ, if doon mo, gusto mo mag-college or gusto mo ma-employ, you better join the interview tomorrow as there will be partner agencies and industries to come to do interview and to scout future employees in their respective agency, in their respective industry. You better grab that one. Even if you think you'll go to college, but still you have a little chance of not going to college but to be employed, you join the interview tomorrow. And of course, if you choose entrepreneurship because of degree, employment, college education, and entrepreneurship, you continue honing your skills, the skills we have started giving you today. So with that, I'd like to congratulate you, to thank you, and once again, we in DP Tangkog City, including the LGU, your parents, and all the stakeholders, are having high hopes and prayers that you will continuously chase for the brightest future that you can have. As we continuously say, what is our tagline? Everybody, shine Tangkog stars. Say it again. Shine Tangkog stars.
Oh, Cristi National High School together with our principal,